It's time for a Bloomberg exclusive. ST Microelectronics, which gets over 10% of its revenue from Apple, says it sees revenue growing above analyst estimates this year, despite slowing demand for its smartphone chips. Its president and CEO, Carlo Bozzotti, joins us now. Great to have you with us, Mr. Bozzotti.
Well, thank you for coming in. Thank you for the invitation.
A decent set of numbers that you reported today. What are you seeing, though, in terms of demand from customers on smartphone chip demand?
Well, I think it's really... I would say on the first half of this year is below expectations, but we expect, on the other hand, a very strong surge moving from H1 to H2.
What about the rebalancing that you're making in the company to sort of move away from the consumer towards other businesses like auto and industrial? How is the rebalancing going?
Well, I think it's going pretty good. You know, we have now about 30% of our revenues is on automotive, and 27% is on industrial customers and industrial applications. And just to give you a sense, smartphone is about 18%. So smartphone is an important piece of our business, but certainly it is much smaller than the bulk, the core that we have with automotive and industrial together.
Well, just to finish up on smartphones, Carlos, what are you hearing from your customers? What's the latest on smartphone chip demand?
Well, as I just said, demand in the first half of this, during the first half of this year was pretty weak, below what we had anticipated. But we see now a strong surge of demand moving from the first half of this year to the second half. So we expect very strong second half demand on smartphone. And again, as I just said, overall, smartphone is less than 20% of our total revenues.
Right, and it's thanks to you, in fact, that the portfolio of ST Micro has moved away from purely smartphones and into things like the automotive industry and industrial. What are you looking for out of the automotive industry for the rest of the year? And indeed, more broadly on smart car adoption, if you like, automotive, electric cars and cars that drive themselves and so on.
Well, overall, we expect to grow our automotive business very materially this year. Last year, and this is 17 over 16, we grew 10% in our automotive. There was an acceleration at the end of the year. The first quarter of this year, again, Q1 over Q1, we grew 17.4%. Mm-hmm. And we expect that overall in 2018, our automotive business will grow in between 15 and 17%. So indeed, it's a material growth. And, you know, we are working very hard with a lot of new technologies, new products to meet the requirements of two fundamental trends in the automobile. One is car digitalization with all the new products to support the driver to make driving safer, and of course semi-autonomous and full autonomous drive. So this is one trend. Yeah. And the other trend is certainly car electrification and all the new technologies to make electric cars more efficient from a power consumption point of view.
Mr. Bozzotti, so far the transition that we just talked about, the rebalancing, you've done without any M&A. Are you looking for M&A opportunities from here, though?
No, I think we are looking, of course, at M&A opportunities. This is more to reinforce what we have. Our portfolio of products, portfolio of application is pretty broad.
Yeah.
We serve four end markets, automobile, industrial, of course, personal electronics, but also, let's say, communication infrastructure and computers. And we have a portfolio that is broad, ranging from analog to sensors, from microcontrollers to digital, from power to specific automotive. And any M&A would be to reinforce what we have and to complement geographically.
Yes. The euro has weakened against the dollar this year. Do you expect that to continue, and what impact will it have on your business?
This we cannot say, and this we'll never say. What I can say that during the last 12 months or so, there was a significant strengthening of the euro. We have absorbed this properly because, as you know, we have a base in Europe with expenses in the euro currency that is an important base. But during the last 12 months, this has been material as a change, but we have been able to absorb this aggravation in our cost. And we noticed that during the very recent days there was, let's say, a weakening of the euro, and this, of course, will be an advantage for us.